Veronica, you just...
She'll be up.
Yeah, I was feeling a little restless.
I don't know what you mean. Hey, some party.
Yeah, some party.
That was quite a bomb that Reginald Love dropped.
Yeah.
I guess the New Year's not shaping up the way you planned it, right?
I always love New Year's. It's supposed to be a really terrific time, but... Wally, this time I'm scared.
Because of Reginald Love's job offer?
No, because of Mitch and Reginald. I really am worried.
I don't work for you anymore. You got that, Reginald?
Watch it, Blake. You're on pretty shaky grounds.
It looks like you're the one that's near the edge.
When are you going to wise up? You're in no position to make demands on me or anyone else in Bay City.
I disagree.
I could have you back in prison before the sun comes up.
Maybe you'd like to share a cell.
And what would happen to dear Felicia then?
Leave her out of it, Reginald.
Come on, Blake. Admit it. Felicia is what this is all about.
Listen, I'm sorry about how things turned out at the party.
Me too. It was all my fault.
Let's just forget it, huh? I had a great time with you tonight.
Me too. I wish it didn't have to end.
Yeah. You know, it's times like this when I wish we were like Cass and Kathleen.
What do you mean?
They're married. Get to spend the whole night together.
Well, you know, Scott, some people don't wait till they're married.
Cheryl, look, I know you're mad at my mom, but she's right about what she said.
Yeah, slow down. She didn't even take her own
advice. Don't start, Cheryl.
I can't help it, Scott. We love each other, don't we?
Yeah, but I just think there's a lot of things that we're not, you know, looking at here.
You know, MJ and Adam are in love.
You know where they are today?
Where?
His place. And I have a feeling like I won't be seeing MJ till morning.
You wouldn't shoot me with that, would you, baby?
You.
Sure, it's me, baby. Who else would it be? Come on, don't do that. I'm not going to try and hurt you.
Leave me alone, Chad.
What are you afraid of me for? What's this? Huh? I don't believe this.
I told you when I was in Chicago, I just want you to leave me alone.
My baby, I don't hold grudges. I know you didn't mean those things you said to me in Chicago.
What are you doing here?
I wanted to welcome the new year in with you. You know how sentimental
I am. I told you I don't want to ever see you again.
Yeah. Those big gray eyes say something different.
How could you do this? How could you attack me like that?
Come on, sweetie, you know how much you'd like to be surprised.
No, you can't do this to me.
Besides, listen, after you read me the Riot Act Chicago, I wasn't sure I'd get another chance to.
I want you to get out of my car right now.
I love you. Get all hot.
I mean it, Chad.
Come on, can't we even talk?
No, we have nothing to talk about. Just get out.
Then what? You ought to know that.
No. I'll set the table and you do the dishes.
Maybe I better stay single.
And miss all those great breakfasts I'll make you on cold winter mornings.
How about if we just stayed in bed?
Well, how about we have breakfast in bed?
Now you're talking. Just once, for old times.
No!
Sweetie, don't fight it. Come on. Cheryl, are you there?
Wait a minute. Scott.
What's wrong?
MJ, something's happening in her car. Call Adam, hurry.
I know your heart's in the right place, but you cannot
seriously consider going to work for a man who may have had something to do with Zane's death.
We don't know that for sure.
Well, Mitch thinks so, too. That's what he said. And that's what's bothering you, right?
It may have something to do with it.
So what are you going to do?
You know, it was never really proven that Zane's death was linked to Reginald Love.
Well, not yet, no.
Well, until I can really prove it, I think I have to accept that he had nothing to do with it.
How can you do that after what we already know about the guy?
Wally, if I want to get on with my life, I have to do that. I mean, Zane would want me to do that. It's not like I've got 100 options here. I've lost everything.
Not your friends.
Oh, I know. And I love each and every one of you. But I'm the one that's got to pick up the pieces and go on.
And why do you look so worried?
Mitch.
His opinion means a lot to you, doesn't it?
I guess so. So it is yours.
Yeah, but I'll bet you'd rather have him here now with you than me.
You're wrong. You're absolutely wrong, especially the way you're thinking of it. It's just that I'm worried that something is happening at Tops.
Why?
I got the distinct feeling that Mitch went back to Tops to have it out with Reginald.
This is not about Felicia.
I'd say you protest a bit too much.
This is just between me and you, Reginald.
Do I have to remind you how much you owe me, Mitch?
You've got your pound of flesh.
If it weren't for me, you'd still be back in that cesspool waiting your turn to come up for parole.
Why don't you skip with the threats?
I'm merely reminding you of your debts.
Like I said, my debts have been paid.
Oh, I'm sure I'll think of lots more things for you to do. If you don't mind, it's getting late.
Wait a minute, Reginald.
This discussion is over.
Not by a long shot.
I'd watch my tone if I were you, Mitch.
It's a two-way street, and from the way that I see it, both sides are against you.
Is that supposed to frighten me?
Don't make me come after you. Because if I do, I'm no Vince McKinnon, and I won't miss.
Now, baby, don't fight it.
Go, MJ!
Come on, just a little sugar.
Go, let's go! Leave her alone! Let her go!
MJ, are you all right? I heard the horn. What happened?
I caught. Did
it hurt you?
My God.
Did it hurt you?
No.
You're shaking like a leaf. Did you get a good look at him? Let's go inside. And Adam will find him. I know he will.
What time do you get off work?
Perfect. Just hurry, okay?
You'll see.
Bye.
Ooh, that looks great.
Help yourself.
Thanks, I'm starving.
Sarah, are you going to tell me what this is all about?
You have 5 minutes. Do you want to go fix your makeup or anything?
But wait a minute. You didn't find him, did you?
Dream.
No way. You couldn't have.
4 minutes, 29 seconds, and counting.
Sarah, is it Tony?
It's just a blind date. I'm not going to say anymore. And go fix your face.
You heard the lady.
I can take over down here. Will you go already?
Mr. Wright, huh?
So, Jamie, how about another sandwich? Sarah speaking.
Sarah, this is Cheryl.
Oh, hi, Cheryl.
Is Jamie there?
Cheryl, I don't need a doctor.
Oh, yeah, hold on. Joan, just tell him to come to the McKinnon house right away. It's an emergency.
Oh, Cheryl, it's...
I really wish you hadn't done that.
Drink this.
And Jay, are you all right?
Oh, Adam. Oh, I'm so glad you're here.
What happened? What happened?
Some guy attacked MJ in her car.
What? Listen, I want you to take the other guys. I want you to comb this block.
Right.
Sit down.
I'm okay now. Okay. She was shaking all over when I got there. Stop it, Cheryl, please.
Now, are you sure that guy didn't hurt you?
Yeah, I'm sure. It just shook me up. That's all.
What did this guy look like?
I don't know. It was so dark.
Listen, Jay, I know this is difficult for you, but if you don't give a description,
yeah,
we can't find this guy.
Adam, it just all happened so fast.
Surely you must have seen him.
I'm sorry. I can't remember.
I can. I saw him, too. When I woke up in jail this morning, I sure didn't expect to be here with you tonight.
No, it's a new day. It's a new year.
Are you sure the babysitter won't mind staying late?
Yes, I'm sure.
He looked so sweet in his little crib right next to your bed.
I tell myself I put him there for his sake. I put him there for mine.
I just hope the phone calls don't wake him up.
They'll stop. Even reporters have to sleep sometime.
I hope we can go to Montana. We can't even go to a restaurant without being interrupted.
Is it that important?
At least I'm here with you. And I have that baby to play with this morning.
Oh, by the way, he likes fruit mixed in with his oatmeal.
You started him on fruit already?
Among other things.
No.
I also started playing poker with him.
Come on.
Nah, don't worry about it. He's no good yet. He keeps trying to draw to an inside straight.
I love you.
1987 is going to be a great year. You'll see. We're going to get to Montana.
I almost believe it.
What's wrong?
Just when I thought everything was perfect.
What is it?
Look at that building up there by the bay, top of it.
Figures. Only they would plaster their name all over the top of a building.
What if the Loves get their way?
You don't think about them tonight.
I have to. What if I'm never free?
You and I come from the same mold. I can fight you on grounds that nobody even knows about.
All this sudden freedom seems to make you go soft in the head.
Did you burn down the North Woods Inn?
First you threatened my life, now you're accusing me of arson.
Did you burn down the North Woods Inn?
I have to admit you've got real style, Mitch. Even if you don't have the brains to go with it. Do you really think I'd ever admit to you something like that, even if I did do it?
No. But it's interesting to see what's behind a man's eyes when you ask him a question like that.
And what do you see behind my eyes?
Enough to know that I was right when I warned Felicia not to get involved with you.
For the last time, Mitch, stay out of it.
For the last time, you stay away from her.
Sure, how long it was. Scott.
What happened?
MJ was attacked in her car.
Are you all right?
I'm fine.
Listen, Cheryl, can you remember anything else about this guy?
I don't know. It was really dark, Adam.
How tall was he?
I guess about Scott's height. Oh, and he had a dark jacket on and dark pants.
Great. Did you get a good look at his face?
Really didn't. Couldn't see his face. Does this mean we're not
going to
be able to find him?
Mm-hmm. Knock him out, Nan!
So you're going to tell me who's coming?
He'll be here any minute.
Come on, Sarah, tell me. Is it him?
Well, maybe it's just someone to get your mind off your mysterious man.
Well, is it, Sarah?
He should be here by now.
He's probably not coming.
You give up fast.
It was him, wasn't it, Sarah?
No, it was not Mr. Wonderful, all right? It was just somebody else. I thought it was a good idea. I'm sorry. I guess I was wrong.
Oh, well. I appreciate the thought, anyway. Honest.
Hey, don't give up on this guy.
Are you kidding, Sarah? Look. Where's James?
Something happened at the McKinnon house.
Is somebody sick?
I don't know. I'm sure Jamie will give us a call.
Yeah, I guess so.
Nancy, I'm really sorry.
Hey. It's his loss, right?
You bet. Hey, I'll see you later.
Yeah, thanks anyway, Sarah.
Husband?
Testing my eyes again, Blake?
Maybe.
And what do you see this time?
All I need to know.
Get out of here before I really lose my temper.
Did you see me shaking, Reggie?
Look, my offer to Felicia Gallant was made in good faith.
Good faith from you is a laugh.
I happen to be a good businessman, Mitch. And I know Felicia's a very capable woman. She will do wonders with this restaurant.
I think you're trying to take advantage of her while she's down and out.
I don't care what you think. It's none of your business.
I'm making it my business.
Having the hots for Felicia Gallant doesn't qualify you as an interested party.
I'm not going to stand by and watch you wipe up the floor with her.
I'm sure Felicia is capable of speaking for herself.
I most certainly can.
What are you doing here?
I rang the bell. No one answered, so I let myself in.
Your timing is impeccable.
Get out of here, Felicia.
This doesn't concern you, Blake.
I'm telling you to stay out of it.
Stop it, both of you. Reginald is right. I don't need anyone doing my talking for me.
Come on, I'm taking you home.
No, Mitch. I've done a lot of thinking and I've made a decision. A big decision.
Now, the next part of Another World.
I've decided to accept your offer.
Are you crazy?
Excellent.
Come on, let's get out of here.
Mitch, no.
You heard the lady.
I thought you said we were friends. I'm telling you, don't do it. You don't know what you're getting
Mitch,
into.
I have to get on with my life.
What, by jumping into quicksand?
That's enough, Blake.
I haven't even started.
This is my restaurant.
No, Reginald. Not for long, it isn't. Your offer was a good one. But the only way that I will accept is if I do have a lease option. And at the end of 2 years, Tops will be all mine.
That's the deal.
You're taking the man at his word?
It'll all be in writing.
That's the second joke of the moment, Reginald. A contract is not worth the paper that it's written on with him.
Mitch, I understand and appreciate your concern, but I really can take care of myself.
I thought you said that we were friends.
We are friends, but this has to be my decision. I need something to do, and I need this money. You know that.
So what are you going to do? Sell your soul for it?
I think it's time we got down to business, Felicia.
I agree.
I'm prepared to offer you salary plus 10% of the gross for the first 2 years.
Make that 20% the first year and 30% the second year.
You drive a hard bargain.
You either want me or you don't, Reggie.
All right. Agreed.
I also want something else understood up front. That I will never work for you, ever. You may own this building, Mr. Love, but Tops will have to be mine. I will set the tone here, and I don't want any interference from you.
You will have complete autonomy.
I also want you to know up front that I plan to exercise my buyout option after the first 2 years.
In 2 years, this restaurant will be yours free and clear.
Then we have a deal.
When can you start? to the Love Tower.
Mitch? Mitch.
You're a phony.
Don't do this, please.
I fight for you, and what do you do?
I don't ask you to fight for me.
I thought you said we were friends. I go to bat for you, and you make a deal with him.
Look on the bright side, Mitch. Maybe Felicia will give you your old bartender's job back.
You go to hell. But then again, you're halfway there.
Mitch. Mitch. Please wait.
I tried to find you after the fire at the Northwoods Inn.
You did?
Yeah.
Well, I tried to find you, too.
Really?
Yeah, I was even going to put up a sign.
I was going to put up an ad in the personals.
You were?
Yeah. Desperate to find beautiful blonde with the greatest blue eyes I've ever seen.
How about desperately seeking Tony?
Well, I guess we think alike.
Hey, Nan, have you seen my...
Sarah, how's it going?
Fine. Hey, Catlin told me about the appeal. That's wonderful.
Yeah.
Thank you.
We want to do a little celebrating here without the press hounding us.
Well, you can. How about two Irish coffees?
You work here?
I think so. It looks like you two need a little privacy.
That doesn't sound too bad.
Go into the kitchen. Even I can manage the rest.
Oh, thanks.
Just make sure nobody wants anything to eat. The kitchen's off limits.
You know, when Sarah called and said she was going to fix me up with a blind date, I was kind of worried. You know what blind dates are like.
Yeah, nerds. I was afraid of that, too.
I guess deep down I knew this would be different.
Yes, so did I. I hope Sarah didn't drag you away from a New Year's Eve party or anything.
No. I worked a graveyard shift down at Corey Publishing.
You're kidding.
But one day I'm going to get my reporter stripes.
Matt Corey is my brother-in-law.
Are you serious?
I didn't know we had so much in common.
Okay, Nancy. In 30 words or less, where the heck have you been all my life?
Hey, you know my sister Julianne?
Yes. Sure. Hi, your brother did so much for me today.
Well, that's the only reason I consented to be seen with him this evening.
All right, well, come on, sit down, have a drink.
Oh, thanks.
So, did you see your son?
Oh, I sure did. I missed him.
Yeah.
Do you think we're going to hear from Peggy Lazarus soon?
Well, you heard her. She's not saying.
She's not going to let us go to Montana. I just know it.
You don't know that.
You didn't hear her when she came to visit.
Well, you made her pretty mad.
That's not it, and you know it. She's in the Love family's back pocket.
Why do you find this love? It is so beautiful.
You'll live, but I want you to get some rest.
Well, don't worry. I'm going to make sure she goes straight to bed.
Would you two stop babying me?
Oh, look here, Ms. Police Person. You were pretty shook up when I got here.
Yeah, but I'm fine now.
Well, just take it easy. Take care, Brad. You gave me quite a scare.
I'm sorry.
I'm never going to let anybody hurt you again.
He didn't hurt me. It just all happened so fast.
Well, come on. Let's get your things. You know, we still got a date tonight.
Oh, boy. I really messed everything up, didn't I?
We're still going to be together, just like we planned. I'm never gonna let you go. What's wrong?
Why do you think MJ couldn't remember what that guy looked like? I mean, she was probably staring at him right in the face when she was fighting him off.
She was probably just too afraid to think straight.
She's a cop, Scott. She's trained to do that.
It's probably a little different when it happens to you. Just panic, I guess.
Yeah, I guess.
Thank you.
know, I still don't understand why MJ can't remember what that guy looked like.
Yeah, it's pretty weird.
Not even the color of his eyes, anything.
I think she probably just freaked out.
But now the police will never be able to find him.
I don't think he's dumb enough to come around here anymore. He's probably just looking for a purse or something.
What was that?
I don't know. Stay here.
No, Scott, I'm scared. There are plenty of police around here. Let them look in the bushes.
Who's there? Hey, wait a second.
Come on.
Is anybody there?
Happy New Year, Brittany.
Trying to talk your girlfriend into keeping me in the slammer?
I have no influence over Peggy's decisions.
That's right. I was simply taking into consideration that Brittany likes to run away a lot.
Peggy, this isn't a time.
Wait a minute. I want to talk to you.
Why?
Brittany was alone the last time she tried to run away. I'm going to see to it that she's never alone again. Now, if you let us go to Montana, I will have her back in court whenever you want. I give you my word.
You know, I think I should have some say over this.
I bet you do.
I am the injured party. I think it would be in everyone's best interests if Brittany were allowed to go to Montana. Any place but here.
What?
You heard me.
I know this trial's been very difficult on everyone.
And the appeal won't be easier.
You give me your word that you'll have her back here when she's needed?
I already did.
All right, then I'll recommend that Brittany be released in your custody.
That's the sentence I love.
You can go wherever you want.
Thank you. Why are you doing this?
Brittany, I'm not a cruel person. I just want to see justice served.
Let's get out of here, all right?
Not yet, Lazarus. I want to buy you a drink.
Thanks, Dad.
We'll be at a table very far away.
Montana, here we come.
Why did Mr. Lutz do that?
Oh, he must have an ulterior motive.
Who cares? As long as we're out of here.
Brittany? Hi. Mom told you were released.
Oh, thanks to her.
Wonderful.
Hey, sit down.
Yeah.
Well, I don't want to intrude.
No, no, no.
Hey, you better intrude while you can. They're getting ready to go to Montana.
Yes.
Great. Thank you for doing that, but what made you change your mind?
You should thank your father. He can be very persuasive.
You talked to him?
Yes, at the party.
What'd he say?
He said he wants Brittany out of Bay City.
Well, I'm aware of that, but I thought you had your mind all made up about that.
Oh, yes, I did. I told him I couldn't allow it. She's a very bad risk. But then he made me an offer I couldn't refuse.
Which was?
He's going to have his security men keep an eye on Brittany.
You're kidding.
Nope, so now I don't have to worry about her taking off, and you don't have to worry about publicity.
Dad did that.
These are from Mr. Edwards.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Now, everyone has what he wants.
Sit down. I'll buy you a drink.
Yeah, join
sit
us.
Yeah, come on.
Hey, I want to propose a toast.
All right, all right. As always.
To my first client. And the man she loves.
Yeah. Hey,
to a bright future. Here, here.
Look, no back talk, MJ.
Come on, Ed. You know what Jamie said. I'm fine.
Give me a coat. Sit over there on that couch.
Yes, sir.
I want you to lay down. Get yourself comfortable. Come on. Lay back.
Come on.
Give me these shoes. Yeah. I'm going to get you nice and comfy before you know it.
Feeling better already.
Here. Here we go.
Thank you.
Great. How's that?
It's great.
Good. Now, tell me how you really feel.
I feel pretty good.
Yeah?
I feel real secure. Warm. You have a great effect on me.
Is that so? Well, the night is still young, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Well, good. Now that you feel better, maybe you can tell me something more about this guy.
I really can't remember anything yet. Don't you believe me?
Yeah, sure. I believe you. It's just that you're a cop, MJ. I mean, you've had training. You've been through scrapes like this before.
I know, but I wasn't being a cop tonight.
What do you mean you weren't being a cop?
I was coming to see you. It was all I was thinking about.
I understand.
What am I with you? I definitely don't feel like a cop.
Yeah?
I just feel like a woman.
Very warm woman. Very beautiful. And I am a very, very lucky guy.
Nobody ever made me feel the way you make me feel, then. So...
very special to me, MJ. I'll go get some hot drink.
Those foreign correspondents. Now they'd get to cover wars and stuff. And I guess that's why I wanted to study journalism.
I guess you want to travel all around the world, huh?
You bet.
Me too.
That's part of what I love about being a reporter. It's really exciting.
I bet you're really good at it too.
Well, actually, I'm just a gopher right now.
Oh, well, come on. Everybody's got to start somewhere.
Well, I figure that I'll work my way up, and then I'll prove myself to Mr. Corey.
Oh, well, Max probably got his eye on you already.
Really think so?
You bet. You know what else I think? I think you could probably do anything you set your mind to.
Peggy, I just wanted to thank you one more time before you left.
Just don't do anything foolish.
I won't. I think things are going to go just great for me now. And I'm so happy. I could almost forgive him.
I could never be that happy. Well, I hope the two of you get everything you deserve.
How did you ever marry that guy? He is such an idiot.
We're going to leave for Montana. First thing in the morning, you ready?
First thing in the morning?
As soon as that baby wakes up.
Okay. I'll sleep in the back seat. You drive.
No. You're going to drive. I'm going to navigate. We better get going. We have to pack.
I think you're going to boss me around like this for the rest of our lives.
You love it. You know it.
You know
it. Okay, everybody. We have to leave.
Already?
Yeah.
Call me and tell me where you're going to be, okay?
I will. Don't worry.
I'm going to miss you.
Thank you for being my friend.
Well, thanks,
Brittany, I just want you to know that I'm really happy for you. I'm sure you've got a great future in front of
you. Thanks, Mitch. You do, too. Bye, everybody!
Okay, bye. Drive carefully.
Bye. You have to get there.
Yeah. right.
Bye. Okay, take care now.
Honey, I didn't know you were here.
Well, you ran off without telling me where you were going. I was worried.
I was fine, really.
So where were you?
I think you already know that.
What'd you tell Reginald, love?
I think you know that, too.
You took the job.
I took the job. Look, it's going to be the best thing that we ever did. I mean, it's going to put us right back on top again, Wally.
Right. You're happy, right? Wrong. Why not, Felicia?
Well, I don't know how I feel about things anymore.
It's Mitch. You're upset because he didn't want you to take the job.
He was there when I told Reginald. It was awful.
That guy's awfully important to you, isn't he? Yeah. Don't answer. I already know the answer.
Where are you going?
I'm going to go start a new year. We've got to be at work in a few hours, boss lady.
Wow. Thanks for being here.
Well, you know I only want what's the best for you, my friend.
I know. And that's exactly what I want for you. And for all of our friends. And also for Zane. Don't you see that's why this is so important, this restaurant? We can keep an eye on Reginald Love right in his own backyard.
Right. That's what we're gonna do.
So this one is for Zane. Okay.
Zane.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year, good buddy. Now I'm going to see you in the PM.
You are. Go
City. The number for Felicia Galat. Thanks.
Stop worrying. I'm here to protect you, aren't I?
Well, sure it's pretty quiet in here.
Probably because no one else is home.
Yeah, I guess so.
Want some hot chocolate or something?
You?
No, thanks.
Well, it's getting pretty late.
Yeah.
Maybe we should go to bed. You can sleep in Pop's room.
Hi, how you doing?
Everything okay in here?
Yeah, we're fine.
I'll be outside if you need anything.
Okay.
Thanks.
I'll check back on you later.
Oh, that's okay. I'm going to be sleeping on the couch. Well, I guess I'll need some blankets.
going to be warm enough down here.
Yeah. I'll be okay.
Well, I guess I better go upstairs.
Yeah.
Next.
I just want to say, I...
Yeah?
I'll see you for breakfast.
To you by hand-loving ivory liquid. Your hands can feel soft and smooth doing dishes the ivory way. And that's the simple truth. Join us each weekday for the continuing story of Another World.